Good morning, it is early. I'm heading to Terminal 5, Heathrow, for a very, very quick trip to New York, but a very important one. So we're on our way, cannot wait. Literally just arrived in New York City. Start spreading the. I mean, how many New York songs do you want? Holds a special place in my heart, actually, New York. It was the first time when me and Giovanna were 18. We just got back together. The band had just started and we wanted to feel like grown ups and go on holiday together, and we decided to come over to New York one Christmas around this time of year. And we had our first holiday together. Over there. These water towers over there. I'm sure they just put them in because it looks like Spider-Man. No one uses those. Okay, let's start with why am I here? Why have I flown halfway across the world, right in the middle of the busiest time of the year for me, in the middle of Christmas chorus rehearsals, to see a film? Well, it's because it's not just any movie. I'm here for the world premiere of a movie called The Greatest Showman. Now, if you haven't been caught up in the excitement of The Greatest Showman yet, and you haven't seen any of the trailers or the posters or anything, take a look at this.
Ladies and gents, this is the moment you've waited for.
I am not a stranger to the dark.
You're still just the tailor's boy. Hide
away. Better luck with your next job.
Those people will never accept us.
This isn't the life I promised you. Not even close.
But I have everything I want.
Girls, I think I've had an idea. Look out, 'cause here I come. I'm putting together a show.
It's a place where people can see things they've never seen before. Okay.
I'm not scared. Who's that?
And what is your act?
I don't have an act.
Everyone's got an act.
People aren't gonna like it if you put us on stage.
Oh, I'm counting on it.
I believe those are the words of a scoundrel.
A showman. Whistling just a showman. Don't listen to them. They don't understand yet. But they will.
So tell me, do you wanna go? Where it's covered in all the colored lights. Where the runaways are running the night. Impossible comes true, it's taking over you.
Oh, this is the greatest show.
Does it bother you that everything you're selling is fake?
Do these smiles seem fake?
We have more protesters every day.
I tried to freak!
You're risking everything you've built.
Well, how do you think I built it?
The world was ashamed of us.
It's everything you ever need.
But you put us in the spotlight. You gave us a real family.
Have you no shame?
Father, the world is changing.
It's everything you ever need. That is here right in front of you. Just where you wanna be.
No one ever made a difference by being like everyone else.
Yeah, so it's an original movie musical with an incredible cast. You've got Hugh Jackman, Zac Efron, Michelle Williams, Zendaya, everyone. Everyone you want to see, they're in it. So ordinarily, I would obviously be very excited to see this film, and I could just wait until Boxing Day when it's out, go see it at the cinema. But And a very big but. There is a very good reason why I've flown all the way here just for a day to see this film and be at this event tonight. And that reason is a man called Michael Gracey. Oh. Do you know what I think? And for that, Michael deserves it. A change in camera angle. Wow. I mean, New York, you even come with lights that are really good for vlogging. That you can change the angle of in your hotels. Yes, Brooklyn. I can put my feet up while I do it. Look at this. Ah. Where was I? Michael Gracey. Michael Gracey is the director of The Greatest Showman. And guess what?
I know him.
Michael is one of the creative forces behind everything that's going on with The Christmasaurus. He is the reason that The Christmasaurus is being developed into a movie. Yeah, let me give you a bit of context. We're going to flash back to when me and Michael met. So, approximately 8 years ago? 8 or 9 years ago, my friend slash manager slash business partner is Fletch, who's been managing me for about 16 years now, a very long time. We started working on a movie musical project. I can't tell you what that's called, so we'll just call it Schmutter for now. Schmutter was a really exciting project, and it had some amazing songs that we were really, really proud of, and it took us on this incredible journey. We met some amazing people along the way. I won't do any name dropping. Wow. And although that film has still not been made, the most significant thing that happened on that journey was that because of that project, we met Michael Gracey. Now, Michael is very similar to Fletch and I, and we all had loads of different projects on the go at once. And while we were working on Michael would always tell us about this other project he was working on with Hugh Jackman called The Greatest Showman. And when Michael tells you about a project, by the way, or a film, he doesn't just tell you, he tells you. He's the most incredible person at describing stories, and he has this amazing imagination, and, you know, the way he expresses his vision is... I can't even describe it. I can't do it justice. But things take a long time, and years, you know, year after year would go by and things would still be in development. And that brings us to about 2 years ago when I started writing The Christmasaurus. When I got to the end of the first draft, there was, you know, a few people that I wanted to read it in that early form and give me honest feedback. And of course, one of those people was Michael. And I thought I also wanted to send it to him because in my head when I was writing it, I kind of thought this could maybe make a good movie. So right from very early on, we started working on the movie version of The Christmasaurus, which was extremely exciting. So about a year after that, The Christmasaurus book was released, and we knew that we were starting to develop the movie, and Michael gave us the incredible news that he got the green light on The Greatest Showman, and he was about to go into production and start shooting this film that we'd known he'd been working on for a very, very long time. So we were so excited for him, so pleased. It was exciting for me and Fletch, you know, just being on the outside and getting to see our friend make his first ever feature film, his debut feature film. And so we would be having Skype calls and discussions about The Christmasaurus while Michael was here shooting The Greatest Showman, and, you know, we'd want to know all the gossip from set and how everything was going. And so that brings us up to now, and Michael very, very kindly invited Fletch and I out to experience the world premiere with him, so we were obviously honoured to be invited and would never want to miss this moment. It's a big moment for us, it's a huge moment for Michael, and so it's totally worth taking a day out of what we're doing back home. They're once in a lifetime moments. It's not just flying halfway around the world to, you know, to sit in a cinema and watch a movie. It's far, far more than that. So that, in a nutshell, thanks for sticking with me through all that, is why I'm here. Okay, I am ready. So is that guy. I'm ready to go to the world premiere of The Greatest Showman. Dress code said festive. Festive I can do. Thank you.
I just want to talk a little bit about how this all started. I can't really talk about this project without Hugh Jackman. Where's Hugh? So, you know, Hugh brought me this script from Jenny, who is here, and he talked about the idea of turning this into a truly great musical. And you know, that's an amazing thing to ask someone who's a first-time filmmaker, and it started a seven-year journey, and Hugh and Deb and everyone just continued to believe and trust that this would one day become something. And it wasn't until I met the great Benj Pasek and Justin Paul. You know, a musical lives and dies by the music. And the music in this film is just incredible. So thank you so much, guys, really. People need to see you.
Okay, I just got back. It is 2:30 in the morning. The Great Showman is amazing. What a night. Being in that room, sharing that moment with Michael is such an honor. So thank you very much for inviting us. I haven't eaten anything today. I'm gonna talk about the film tomorrow when I wake up and I'm fresh and had some food. Before I go to bed, I am gonna eat these chocolates because I'm so hungry. Oh. This is dinner. Good night. I know it's messy here, but do you guys mind? Just ignore that. Just concentrate on this. Last night was incredible. I cannot tell you. I've never been to a premiere with that kind of atmosphere. It was like a live concert. People were clapping and cheering and singing along. At the end of every song, people applauded like it was a show. And I don't think that's because the audience was, you know, made up of the people who made the movie and the, you know, the cast and crew. I genuinely think that is the kind of response that the movie brings out of you. You literally want to scream and cheer and clap along to the songs. They are incredible. It was so special being in there with all of those people, sitting in the row with the people that made the movie, and seeing Michael's vision come to life. I mean, Michael has the most incredible imagination, and seeing that on the screen now for the first time, you know, after hearing, you know, all of these stories about these moments and seeing the concept art and seeing that brought to life last night was just, you know, I can't describe it. You know how movies have those one or two moments that will, you know, stay in your mind and become the lasting image that you think of? I feel like every song in this film has one of those visual moments. There's this moment at the beginning in a song called Million Dreams where they're dancing on the roof, and you would have seen people dancing on the roof before because that's where people go to dance, right? But you won't have seen people dancing on a roof like this. It is just amazing. And every song has those moments. Rewrite the Stars with Zac Efron and Zendaya. I mean, I can't even describe the choreography for that. When they're on this, I don't want to spoil stuff, they're on this trapeze. Can I say that? I don't know how they, just how you think of that and then actually do that is just, it's amazing. And Ash, who did the all the choreography, is just a genius. The dancing is amazing. And then the music, the songs, I mean, they're just too good. Pasek and Paul, how have you done this? Every song is like the standout song. You know how like musicals normally have one standout song that, you know, is kind of the legacy of that musical? Every song in this film could be that one song from another one. It is amazing. I'm a bit of a fan. I didn't actually get to meet Pasek and Paul last night. You know me, I'm not very good in social situations. Premieres, parties, people, me. But seriously, congratulations. The songs are amazing. Just give those guys all the awards because it's just too good. So to sum up, just being there last night just made me realize how lucky I am to not only be working with Michael and have him part of the Christmasaurus, but just knowing him and experiencing last night with him and all of the team was really special. So thanks for inviting us over. Wouldn't have missed it for the world. Generally, like if I didn't know Michael, I would be seeing this film at the cinema and thinking, God damn! Everyone, go see Greatest Showman on Boxing Day. I'm gonna try and brave the snow, I think. I feel like I should make the most of while I'm here. We've only got a few hours.
Listen, all you New Yorkers.
That's a good idea.
Go outside and build snow.